Hey guys, Ryan here at Signature Edits, and in today's Lightroom Quick Trick, I'm going to show you how the Range Mask feature works in Lightroom and how you can use it to quickly and easily recover those nasty blown up skies in Lightroom in a matter of seconds. Let's get into it. All right, so let's get into it. This is the photo with a basic preset applied just to get that look kind of where we want it. Now let's work on the sky because clearly we have lost a lot of information. In fact, here is the original file. Here's with the preset. We can see that things are pretty blown out. How do you use that range mask? Well, it's pretty easy. We're going to grab our exposure, turn it all the way down on the range mask just so we can see what we're doing and it's super obvious. Then we're going to take this graduated filter. We're going to drag it down like that. So you can see right now it's making everything super dark because our exposure is all the way down. Let's turn on the range mask and set it to luminance. From there, we can actually grab this luminance range. Luminance is just another word for brightness. And we'll take it so that our brightness is only 81% and above is affected in this image, or 90%. And you can see that it's going from affecting everything to just affecting the very brightest portions of our image. This is super quick and powerful because now we can really easy with one fader affect just the sky and the super blown out portions of our image. Now, what can we do to take things further than this? Because we've already taken our exposure all the way down. Well, we can actually take our temperature and grab that, pull it back. And by doing this, we're actually going to add some blue into the sky that wasn't there before. So here's before. And here's after. So you can see we're just adding a little bit of blue into the sky just by dragging that one little slider. Now if things start looking a little bit too aqua or green for your taste, you can just take your tint and take that up a little bit. That'll add some magenta to the sky and make it a little bit less greenish looking. You can see the difference there. And then we can just add a little bit of saturation and we're done. So there's how you do it, using the range mask to save skies in Lightroom. Easy, simple, and effective. Hey, if this was helpful, please smash that like button. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you're looking for free Lightroom presets, you can check out our sample packs in the links below. Make sure to download those today. Take care.